Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope you are doing good. So, students, in the last videos, we have seen about what, where, and how. What can we know, from where can we know, and how can we know about our past. So, in the recent video, we have seen about the two important sources through which we get maximum of our information about the past. First is manuscripts. Manuscripts are written usually on what kind of material, students?
It was on leaves, bark of the tree, skin of animals.
Skin of animal, dried skin of animals is called
parchment.
Okay, so the word manu comes from the Latin language, that means hand. Okay, in next source is inscriptions that are written on hard surfaces. Now, students, I want to ask you that during the excavations, did archaeologists find only such things? No, right? They would have found many other things. So, today we will be seeing what are the other things what archaeologists have found during the excavation and what does the information we get from them and how can we know that is it really a very ancient thing or recent thing? Okay, so we'll see. So, students, what is archaeology? You all know, right? Archaeology is the study of remains of the human past. For example, remains of buildings, paintings, sculpture, tools, weapons. So, all these things will come under the remains of the human past, that means what were left by the early humans. So these might be the places they might have lived, the tools what they have used, stone tools or any other metal tools, or these are the some of the examples of kind of paintings that they might have done on the walls or in the caves. Okay, students, understood now? Archaeologist. Now, who is an archaeologist? Archaeologist is a person who studies the archaeology, the remains found during the excavation, like pots, ornaments, coins, etc. So, these all things will be studied very carefully by the archaeologist so that he get information that what might have happened in the past, what were the different materials used. Such information will be gathered by the archaeologist. So, students, here we can see few things, right? Now, this statue or this pot, so these will be made by the humans only, no? They will be making by their hands. So, the things, the articles that are made by human are called as artifacts. Human-made objects are called artifacts that are found from any site. Okay? And the person who studies all these things are called archaeologist. So, students, how can they know about such articles? Do they find it somewhere? No. They have to dig a particular place, right? And that is called excavation. Now, how can archaeologists tell that what people ate in the past? So, here you can see, students, two pictures are there, right? What are they? They are bones and skeleton of something. Now, on what basis the archaeologists tell that what people might have eaten in the past is by the remains of the bones of the animals or the birds or fishes, whatever they used to eat with the remains, with the bones, if they have remained for so long, then doing research on it, seeing from which animal it can be. So, they will be then deciding what might have people eaten. Now, this is something what they might have eaten, the animals or any birds and all. Now, how can we know what were the grains that humans have consumed at that time? Now, even that can be found out if some plant remains have been still found. Now, plants will decay very soon, so it is very, very, very difficult to find any such plant remain. But sometimes what happens, some seeds or grains or a piece of wood that might have been left over, no? Then that the archaeologists study and then they tell that what kind of plant, what kind of object it is actually. Not only that, students, the plant remain can also be found in form of ashes if they might have burnt it. For usually cooking, they use fire. They would have used fire, no? So from that, if some plant remain is remained in the form of ash, through that also, the archaeologists can tell what people have ate in the past. Students, now these are few things from which we can know. Now, do you think all the objects that were used by the humans would have survived? Now, archaeologists will get all the things what were used by the humans in the past? No. They have got only few things and most of the things will be destroyed. They might have not survived. Now, what can be the reason for the artifacts not to survive so long? And why do we find only few? The main reason is the objects made with the help of stone or bone or burnt bricks or clay or some other metal, as they are strong, they can survive for many years. If something, now we have seen manuscripts. Manuscripts were palm leaves, bark. If they are of not good quality or some very weak, they would not survive. As they were preserved in very careful, very good place, carefully, so they have survived. Now, in the same way, if something, artifact is made up of hard material, then it can survive for a long time. If not, it would have got destroyed. So, that is why we don't find many things related to the past. We find very few. Students, not only archaeologists, there are other people also who study about the past. Want to know who are they? Yes, they are historians. Who are historians? What will they do? They are the scholars who study the past. Now, how do they study the past? They study the past using the information found from the manuscripts, inscriptions and archaeology. Now, whatever the artifacts are found during the excavation, after archaeologists dig up, they take out. Now, in this, historians will also be involved and they study those things and try to find out the information about the particular artifact. Now, what type of information they can found? They can try to find out what is the material, for what might be that article used, what is the shape, is it painted or not, how they might have made it. So, all these things they will try to search. Okay, students? Now, usually people say that historians and archaeologists as detectives, they will act like detectives. Why do the people say so? Want to know? We'll see. Because once they find any clue or any source, that might be during an excavation, if they find a single thing, what they will do? They will try to search more and more about that particular thing. So, whatever is found, then they will try to reconstruct what might have happened, how might it got destroyed, how did they make this metal. Okay, so we find many types of metal, no? Were they doing the same thing at that time? So, when they are trying to search it bit by bit, they used to think it is more adventurous. So, how detectives will try to find out anything that have happened in the past or what might be the criminal or any case they will be studying, no? So, here also bit by bit, the people will be trying to search more and more, more and more. So, this is one of the reasons that people call them as detectives. Student, see, I have few coins for you. Now, you have to tell what is the value of this coin. What is the value of this coin? It is 5 rupees coin, right? Students, but this is a bit higher denomination of a coin. We are having here 10 pice coin, 25 pice, 50 pice that we used to use in our childhood. But here you might have not seen them or you might have not used them from your childhood. Okay. Now students, imagine if any archaeologist find these coins after 100 years, then what kind of information can they get from these coins? First thing, they will try to search what is this material out of which these coins are made up of, how they might have given this shape to the coin, and what are the things written on the coin. For example, if we see this particular coin, on this it is written as Dadabhai Naroji. Maybe it was made on the anniversary, on the remembrance of Dadabhai Naroji. Okay, so here they have given what was his birth time and death time. That means when was he born? 1825 to 1917. So they can get this information. Let's see another coin. On this coin, they have given about Maulana Abdul Kalam Azad. And it was also made on the occasion of his anniversary. Okay. Now, there is one more special coin. This, usually whatever the notes or coins will be made by Reserve Bank of India. It's a government bank, right? So, this was published they have made this coin on the occasion of the Platinum Jubilee of the bank. That means the bank have completed its 75 years. 25 years is Silver Jubilee, 50 years is Golden Jubilee, and 75 years is Platinum Jewelry. Okay, so this was issued in 2010. That means from 1935 to almost 2010, they have completed their 75 years. Okay, students, this is a 10 pice coin. On this, it is written as 1988. That means this coin was issued in the year 1988. So, they can come to know what and when they have made it. Okay, when they have started issuing it in the year 1988. So, archaeologists can get many information like when they have made, year, for what they have issued this. So, you all have got an idea. So, students, now here I have one more object for you to show. That is a glass. Students, for seeing, it may look like an antique, but it is not. Let me tell you, it is not any antique thing. But we can take it as an example. Now, if suppose archaeologists find this glass, now, what will they try to study about from this glass? They will try to study the shape of the glass, the material with which it is built, and the design that is present on this glass. How this glass might have got this design, what might be the technology, what tools they might have used for this. So, we have got an idea, right? How archaeologists will be working and how they will be studying of the different objects. Okay, so hope you have understood the given examples. Students, do you think archaeologists might have found frequently the cloth? Maybe, but if they have found, it can be torn, or will it be looking like a new dress how our parents will buy for us? No, it will not look, because it might have been made many 100 years ago. So, is the possibility is they may find the such small pieces of the cloth or threads like this. So, by studying these threads, they can know what is the material, whether it is a cotton, silk. Okay. So, here they will be trying to study the cloth like this. And very often they don't find the cloths. Even if they find, they may find it in this way. So, students, we have seen today what kind of information the archaeologists can get, or they might be getting from the old coins. For example, we have seen the coins here, the glass, and the thread. Hope you all might have understand the things which I have tried to explain you today. Okay, but I have one more question, students. That how can then archaeologists tell that this glass, how old it is? Suppose if they find the same glass what I have now and you all can see this. This is 100 years old or 10 years old. Just by seeing this, they can understand how old that material is, how old the glass is. But just by seeing it, will they tell that this is 100 year old glass or 200 year old glass? We cannot say just like that. We need proper evidence again for telling what how old it is. How old a paper can be or any particular object and article. So, I will try to tell you. I hope you understand. Okay? Students, to tell whether how old this glass is, the archaeologist will be using a technique called radiocarbon dating. It is called radiocarbon dating. Now, dating here is nothing but to tell the date or the year how old this object is. Okay, students? Now, in this carbon dating, what they will be doing is there will be a particular compound called carbon 14 in most of the objects. When it usually they will be having carbon 12, when it is exposed to nitrogen, it will be becoming carbon 14. So it is little complex. Okay, I'll try to explain you in a simpler way. Now, so even this object will be having carbon 14 in it, and it is believed that one compound of this out of 14, one it will be having the life of 11,460. Then the half life would be 5,730. So it is believed by the archaeologists that to lose half life of the carbon, it will be taking approximately 5,730. It can be a little bit here and there, but usually they will be using the same time. Now, if one compound is losing the half, then it will from carbon 14 it will become carbon 13 half, then it will become 13, then it will become 12 half, then 12. So in this way they will be understanding how old an object is. Okay, students, you have understood now. So half life of the carbon compound will be lost in 5,730 years. Okay, students, you all might have understood this. So, students, these are the different sources how archaeologists will be coming to know what happened in the past, what were the different materials and all the details that I have explained to you today. So, that's it for this module, and we will be meeting in the next video. Bye, students.